Hey guys, what's up? Gunlover here, and figured I'd hit y'all with a new video today. Was browsing around my YouTube feed earlier this morning and saw a bunch of guys, for some reason or another, doing loadout or kit videos of their loadouts of the gear that they wear and the guns that they run and things like that. So here's my little poorly put together, half-assed thing. So here's my little take on what I run when I go to a game.
So we will start with my shirt. This is a 5'11 shirt in multicam. Pretty much all the stuff I have is multicam. I've got a few woodland things, and I actually need to get some more woodland gear for those ops I plan on going to, that I want to be on the woodland side because it's, you know, going to make more sense. But like I said, 5'11 shirt. This is just a temporary belt. I'm getting a Condor belt in the mail here in a few days, so I'll be running that. That'll be in tan. And these are just some multicam pants that I picked up at an Army Navy store, so that's what I've been running. Get my Infidel patch, which I run because I'm an infidel. Fuck you, Allah. My American flag patch and my Elite Force patch. So that's it for the clothes. Now let's move on to the gear. This is my brand new plate carrier that I just picked up the other day. It's kind of a early Christmas present from my mom to me. She, back in July, was like, oh, what do you want for Christmas? And I said, one of these. This is the Condor Gunner plate carrier. It's got tons of Velcro space up here and on the back as well, up at the top. The Velcro space also doubles as Molly real estate, so if there's anything that I wanted or needed to connect over here with Molly, I can do that. I have done so down here. This is a Condor 6-mag mag pouch. Pretty much a lot of the shit that I get is Condor, just because I love their gear. I'm running 5 SOCOM Gear Troy mid-caps. They're 190 rounds each, but I'll generally only put about 120 rounds. I'll just put basically a whole speed loader's worth of BBs in here, because 190 rounds in a mid-cap, to me, that's stupid. You're going to fuck up your spring that way inside the mid-cap, and frankly, I don't see a need for it. I just don't see it. So I run 5 of those, and then I have 1 KWA K120 mid-cap. I used to have 6 of these, but one of the guys on my team bought these SOCOM mags, tried them in his gun, they didn't work, tried them in mine, fed flawlessly, so I said, we'll just trade. So I run 6 mid-caps. It's really generally all I need. Right here, we've got my Phantom dump pouch. Currently, it's just filled with my face protection and my gloves. It's got my mechanics gloves here, got my lower face protection and my eye protection. Got all that. So basically, when I'm up shooting, you know, I have to drop a mag, I can just get right back into it, so makes things easier on me. But eventually I am going to get a battle belt, which the dump pouch will end up going on that, because not for nothing, it's a little cumbersome being right here on my hip a little bit, but it's not that bad. I can live with it. So there's that. Now let's move on to the gun. Now this is my AEG. This is my primary. This is my only gun that I have for now. I intend to get essentially a little armory when I start, you know, making better pay. This is a Spikes Tactical SOCOM ST-15. I say Spikes Tactical, it's licensed through them because this is their gun, because it has the Spikes Tactical logo right here. It's also got Spikes Tactical, Apopka, Florida, USA, which their AR-15s are astounding. This is a Spikes upper rail. This is a Magpul angled foregrip right here. It's amazing. Also, Spike's little spider right there that they have. The mock suppressor up here is a Gemtech mock suppressor. Right now, it's just for looks, as are most mock suppressors, but I have a new barrel, a new Manbolt Type Bore barrel coming in, which is the inner barrel only goes to right about there on the mock suppressor, but when the new barrel comes in, I'm actually going to need that to cover the inner barrel because it's going to come out to almost the end of the mock suppressor. The current inner barrel is a 300 millimeter 6.03 Mad Bull Type O barrel, so I'm going from a 300 millimeter to a 363 millimeter just so I can get a little bit more range and accuracy out of it, because I'm going to need this for the field op in December next month. So I'm going to need some better range out of this thing, because this gun is primarily a CQB weapon. With twos, I'm getting about 330 to 340 FPS, which isn't bad, you know, but again, it's a CQB gun. It's got about CQB range. I was playing with the hop-up yesterday here at the house, and did some adjustments on it, and was actually able to bump this thing from CQB range almost to field range by just playing with the hop-up a little bit. So, you know, for you guys out there who think, oh, just play with the spring and that'll, you know, fix your distance. No, it's primarily your hop-up. So, that's basically it. Normally, as you guys have seen in my prior videos, I do have a Avengers T1 red dot, which would normally sit right here, but the clasp that keeps the sight hooked onto the rail, the screw for it came off, so now I gotta find another screw for it. I'm probably just gonna go out Home Depot and get one, but you can just imagine, you know, red dot being right about there on the body rail. That's about it for that. I normally run a 9.6 battery in it, so you guys have seen it. It gets pretty good, decent rate of fire. The mags fit in perfectly, and they drop out excellent. You know, the fact that I can just throw a mag in here and then just have it just drop straight out makes life so much easier when I'm on the field, so I don't have to, you know, waste time getting one back in here. I can just drop it, and plus they're mid-caps. These things are durable as hell anyway, so I never have to worry about them. So there's that. Let's see, what else? Oh, this will become my Polar Star gun when I eventually save up enough money to get a fusion engine and the rig and the pilot and the air tank and the line and all that stuff. This will be my Polar Star gun. Hopefully, I'm close to having saved up enough money to get the fusion engine itself. Still about $300 to $400 away from getting the complete package, just because I want to do everything at once. But after Thanksgiving and Christmas and New Year's, with all the hours I'll be getting at work and the money I'll be getting from relatives and family members and everything, I should have enough to turn this thing into a Polar Star finally, because Polar Stars are the shit. I don't care how many people bitch about them. I primarily want it for the trigger response, because I'm a whore for semi-auto with Polar Stars, because I love that instantaneous trigger response. So yeah, that's it for the gun. We'll just move on to one final thing, and that'll wrap it up for this video. And this is, last but not least, my Emerson PJ helmet. It is very, very, very comfortable. I got an adapter right here on the arc rails, which will fit the Contour. Fantastic helmet. I cannot recommend this thing highly enough. It is amazing. I love it to death. It's got Velcro all on the tops, and it's got Velcro here on the back. I got the Opsoviet Lone Wolf patch that I don't know why I still have this patch. I should probably just burn it, considering Opsoviet sucked, like, a lot. every single one I went to, it sucked. And then there was this travesty of an op hostile takeover, for those of you who went. I've got mixed reports back about that op. I went to it. I left after the first evolution. I was like, this was a waste of my time. But hopefully this Black Sheep op next month on the 13th will not be a massive disappointment. I've looked into Black Sheep ops, in the past. And from what I was able to find, they are very well ran and very well thought out. So, that is that. So yeah, this is my Emerson PJ helmet. It's got a little bit of a spray pattern type deal going on with it. I like the fact that it does have the holes in it, which can be a double-edged sword. I mean, I like the holes in it because it vents out the air and vents out the heat that can generate under these helmets, because I've worn helmets without the air, without the holes in them. It's very, very hot, so it's good for that. But on the downside, you know, and as you guys have seen in one of my videos that I just released not too long ago, BBs can get under these holes, and believe me, that shit hurts a lot. Hurts a lot. Does not feel very pleasant. So yeah, that sucks. So yeah, that's one of the downsides of having these holes. But it's a risk that you run, so I just choose to let it go and just let that be. So that is it for this video, you guys. I'm gonna go ahead and put these mags back, because if I don't do it now, I'm going to forget later on, and I'm gonna get pissed at myself. And I don't want to be pissed at myself, because, you know, I just don't want to. I want to be happy. I want to be happy. So yeah, that is going to do it for this video. Like, comment, subscribe. You know, if you want to ask any more questions about gear, gun, helmet, my life, whatever the hell, you know, go ahead and leave them down in the comment section below. I'll get to it whenever I feel like it. Because you guys know I can be a jackass when needed. So, yeah. But that is going to be it for me. This is Gunlover64 signing off. And, yeah. Have a good day, guys.